Greetings one and all, and welcome to this math video. Today we'll be considering a question on vectors. And notice what this says. It says the vectors P and Q are defined as P equals 12, negative 5, and Q equals negative 6, 5. And these are column vectors. They are column vectors. They are written in column form. That is to say, their orientation is like a column. And so we have the following to do. They say, calculate the column vector P plus 2Q. So knowing and understanding that P equals to 12 and negative 5, and knowing and understanding that Q equals to negative 6 and 5, the question is saying, well, find what is P plus 2Q. So note that the vectors P and Q are defined as P equals 12 and negative 5, like we saw in the question, and Q equals negative 6 and 5. So, since P is this and Q is this, the following computation holds. So we're going to perform this computation. So P, so we replace P with what? 12 and negative 5, so let's do that. And we have plus 2. Because they are close to one another, this is actually 2 times Q, all right? So we have 2 times Q. What is Q? Q is negative 6 and 5. We just substituted the values. So let us multiply 2 and this vector. So 2 times negative 6 is going to be negative 12. And 2 times 5 is going to be equal to 10. So that means that 2 times this vector is equal to negative 12 and 10. So now we have to add. So we're going to add corresponding entries. So we say 12 plus negative 12. What is 12 plus negative 12? Well, 12 plus negative 12 is actually 0. Now what is negative 5 plus 10? Say for example, you owe me $5 and you have $10. So you owe me $5 and you have $10. You pay me back the $5 that you owe me, and now you're left with $5. So P plus 2Q is actually equal to the column vector 0, 5. Let's consider the other question. So we are done with AI. So this was AI. We're done with AI. Now let's consider AII. So they say that the value of M, so they want us to calculate the value of M. What is M going to be when MP equals to MQ? So what is the value of M? How much is M going to be when MP equals MQ? So let's consider that. So if MP equals to MQ, then what does that mean? We keep the M, and we just substitute the value for P. What is P? Remember we saw that P is 12 and negative 5. So we just substitute that in, 12 and negative 5, all right? And we have Q here, and we just plug it in. So Q is just negative 6 and 5. How do we know that? We know that from the question they gave us, negative 6 and 5. So Q is negative 6 and 5, so we insert that here. So now we have, so MP equals to MQ really is M, 12 and negative 5, equals M, negative 6 and 5. Now let's multiply. So M times 12 is 12M, and M times negative 5 is negative 5M. Again, and let's look at the other side. M times negative 6 is negative 6M, and M times 5 is 5M. Okay, so that means that if MP equals to MQ, then that means that these two vectors, this vector and this vector, are equal. All right? That means that this vector and this vector are equal. If MP equals to MQ, then that means that this vector and this vector are equal. Okay, so these two vectors must be equal if MP equals to MQ. So since the two vectors are equal, this is very important, since the two vectors are equal, it follows that their corresponding entries are also equal. That means that if this vector equals to this vector, then that means that 12m must be equal to negative 6m. Why? Because that's what it means to be equal vectors, right? If these two vectors are equal, that means this entry, the top two entries, must be equal to each other, right? And so that means that 12m must be equal to negative 6m. And that's what we have here. 12m must be equal to negative 6m. The same thing applies for the bottom, right? If these two vectors are equal, then that means that their bottom numbers or their bottom entries must also be equal to each other. So negative 5m must be equal to 5m if these vectors are going to be equal. Okay, so that's what we have here. Negative 5m equals to 5m. Okay, so let us solve these two linear equations. Okay, so here we have 12m equals to negative 6m. Let us send the negative 6m on the other side. And if we do that, the negative here is going to change into a positive. And we're left with 0 on the right side. So now we have 12m plus 6m. And what is 12m plus 6m? Well, that's 18m. That's 18m. So we have 18m equals to 0. But we want to get rid of this 18, right? And 18 is multiplied by m. And so in order to get rid of it, we must do the opposite. So what is the opposite of multiplication? Well, we can look at division as being the opposite of multiplication. So we divide both sides by 18. So we divide this side by 18 and this side by 18. And so we have 18 divided by 18. Those two cancel out. We're leaving us with just the m. And 0 divided by 18, in fact, 0 divided by any number is 0. So m here in this case is 0. Okay? M in this case is 0. But let's go on the other side and let's see what we have. Notice that we have negative 5m equals to 5m. What we're going to do is we are going to send, just like we did in the previous one, we're going to send the 5m over the equal sign. And because this is a positive 5m, because it's a positive 5m, when we send it over the equal sign, it will become a negative 5m. And so, what is negative 5m minus 5m? Well, that's actually equal to negative 10m. Because if you owe me $5 and you owe me an extra $5, you in fact owe me $10. So we have negative 10m equals to 0. Okay, so we really want to get rid of this negative 10m. And so in order to get rid of this negative 10m, what we're going to do is we're going to divide both sides by negative 10. Because negative 10 and m are connected by multiplication, if we want to get rid of it, we must perform the opposite, which is division. So we divide both sides by negative 10. So negative 10 divided by negative 10, and also divide this side by negative 10. So negative 10 divided by negative 10 is simply those two, they cancel each other, leaving us with 1. And so we have m and 0 divided by negative 10 is simply 0, because 0 divided by anything is still 0. So m is going to be equal to 0. So in both cases, we get m equals to 0. So therefore, the value of m when mp equals to mq is 0. Let's consider the next question, A III. And III asks us for the magnitude of P. And this is how we represent magnitude. We put the P in the middle, the vector P in the middle, and we have these bars here, right? And the bars means that, hey, we're trying to consider the magnitude of P. So let us consider that, right? So this is question A III. So what is the magnitude of P? So notice that the vector p from the question, we have that the vector p is 12 and negative 5, right? So the vector p is 12 and negative 5. So thus we have that its magnitude. In order to find the magnitude, what we must do is we must take the top number or the top entry and square it. So that's why we have 12 squared. So we take the top number and square it. And then we're going to add it to the bottom number. The bottom number squared. So it's going to be negative 5 squared. So we take 12 and we square it. And we take negative 5 and we square it. Now what is 12 squared? Well, 12 squared is of course 144. And 144, let's write that better. 12 squared is 144. And what is negative 5 squared? Well, negative 5 squared is basically the same thing as asking what is negative 5 times negative 5. And negative 5 times negative 5 is 25. And what is 144 plus 25? Well, that's actually equal to 169. So that's how we got the 169 here. Okay? All right, so the square root. What is the square root of 169? In other words, what number that I could use to multiply by itself to give me 169? And 13, if you know that 13 times 13 is indeed 169. So therefore, the square root of 169 is 13. So the magnitude of P, the magnitude of this vector P, is equal to 13. And what do we mean when we say magnitude? We basically mean size or length. So say, for example, this was the vector P, right? Let's say this is the vector P. What we're saying is that we want to know how long is this vector. Or we want to know its size. We want to know its length. And so that is what the magnitude is. The magnitude is the length or the size of the vector, how big the vector is. Okay, that brings us to the end of this video. Thank you for your time and attention, and I'll see you in the next video.